All right, so we're here at the paint shop today up at Chris Brown's Brain Bucket. And as you can see, he's got everything in epoxy primer. There's a hood.
Well, you know, you could build this car to look like it was built in 1939, and if you get the paint wrong, you ruined everything.
Fenders, fender skirts, and then the car is in here. Definitely starting to look like something. You can see our doors, fenders carrying through. Kind of a special feature. It's got it all taped off. See how nice and clean the engine compartment is. Plugged off a lot of the holes in there. Really nice engine compartment on these cars. These louvers are super cool looking underneath here. I like how they did the louvers from the factory on that angle. They just do them straight. They look nice. They look good with the motor in here. You can see here's the other door, fenders going back, and then you can see on the car here, it's looking pretty good. Got our fin going, pretty snazzy. I'm liking it. I think it's gonna look great. American Collector's Insurance.
So now I got everything in a box of primer. That was ready for body work. Everything is locked down, sealed. Any of the metalwork that needed to be done and straightened out is now done. And now we're gonna get to the next step.
So it's body work, then primer, then paint?
Yes.
It's a rush to the finish line.
We gotta offset this. See the yellow? See how the yellow is bigger than the blue?
So when it came down to the machine work and some of the ideas I had for the door panels, I actually picked up the phone and gave Jason Poole a call, and he's a blast from the past. You know, we go way back to the OCC and American Chopper days.
That'll be our water jet piece, and then the logo will exceed the face of it.
You're gonna take that, you're gonna do whatever you can. There's your water jet piece.
It was actually a tremendous amount of fun.
This is gonna be like almost like the brand of the car in that location.
It's like the badge, the money badge.
Yeah.
I always liked Jason. And we had a lot of fun. We really did in our younger years. So it was fun to revisit that. And now we have kids and families, and it was just nice to work together.
That's how it's going to be split.
Something like that, whole bodies.
Exactly, and it would just be in two pieces. And send me a screenshot of that if you don't mind, because you know, maybe I do copper and brass, polished copper and polished brass on that to give myself a, you know, kind of a dramatic two-tone look.
All right, so what we have here is a template of our doors. They're really important, these doors, more so than most doors as far as interior goes, because in order to get the fenders to work the way they did, we had to suicide the doors.
Once you open the doors, now you get the interior on the exterior, which you don't get in a normal conventional opening door. And so I really capitalized on that from a design standpoint.
What I'm doing here is just kind of coming up with a layout. I want to do this out of aluminum, maybe do some brass or brushed nickel inlay for these two kind of Art Deco looking pieces.
A lot of people just do leather panels or material panels, and I thought, man, what a perfect spot for design real estate.
I want to do my logo in the same capacity. I'll machine it and do like an inlay in it. This is the armrest. This here is for rolling up the window, and then here's for just opening the door. So it's a pretty simple panel, but I'm trying to make it a little bit more exciting. I think it's going to be a big aspect on the car. These are our door panels. These are going over our leather doors, and we're cutting the brushed stainless inserts, real Art Deco. And this is gonna mount to the leather. I'm gonna drill and tap holes, both from behind, and then insert these pieces. And I think they're gonna look sick. Going back and forth,
they're all identical.
Oh, dude, we're done.
Done.
Dude, that looks so good. Doesn't that look nice, man? Isn't that gonna look good on them door panels like that?
I'd like it.
I like it a lot.
See, it moves a little bit, but to be honest with you, like, it's this dark color, so.
That is gonna be so good on them door panels. What do you think? That brushed stainless,
it's so
kinda
cool,
like,
yeah.
Nice, right? Like, mellow.
I think it's great, man.
And I think, look, that edge wipes right off.
Okay, so this is the first I'm seeing the paint.
I always thought, man, if I'm gonna do this thing, I wanna go with the darkest blue I could find without it being black. And I think it shows so much nicer.
But I'm really digging it. I think it's a great color.
I don't think there's a better color on the planet. I don't think there's another color. We could paint this car 50 times and I still think you'd be liking this dark blue better than anything.
I'm very happy with it. You can see the engine bays nice and clean. All right, so there's our five wheels. Nice body color, rear fender, front fender, ready to go. And here our other front fender and rear fender, looking good. Fender skirts, all little bits and pieces, dash stuff, some of the stuff for the seats, steering wheel, fender brackets. Got our trunk looking real slick, got our hood. Crazy.
You know, at one point we were 9 days out.
9 days out.
I just felt like, man, I think we got a shot at this. I didn't know, because the thing didn't look good. I mean, the car did not look like, it looked like, I think most people would be like, dude, you got another year. You know, not like 9 days.
Got the engine over here, original Zephyr scripted heads. I'm doing quad carbs, which I've not seen on a V12 motor before. Looking pretty snazzy. I'm getting excited about this one. All right, I'm just pulling up to the interior shop here. Seems like I may have made a mistake on the leather. I was going with a red. I thought it was a darker red. Seems like it's a bright red, and it's not going to work for this project. It's just not going to work.
So one of the biggest setbacks on this car really was the interior, and it was purely my fault. I mean, nobody else's fault.
This is the actual color of the car. That's the red that we're not probably going to go with.
I looked at the samples. They looked more maroon, and when all the material came in, I went there and it was red, and it was so red, like my heart like dropped when I saw it.
Yeah, I made a big mistake on this red. I just think it's too bright.
So then I had to go to the boss, which is my wife, who knows about these things, and she straightened me out pretty quick, and she picked this color interior that we ultimately went with, and wow. I mean, we went from what I think would have been okay. It would have worked, but it wouldn't have been as rich.